Okay, so welcome everyone to this acrylic painting class where I'm going to be demoing the orange, silver, and acrylic. And I've got out this is my handy wet palette. That's Masterson, like Master and Son. And you can buy them at Blick or anywhere. And you'll see there's a sponge down there that's wet. And it comes with this special paper. And the paper absorbs the water, so your acrylic paint stays nice and wet. So in the desert, that's a really good thing. So I've got out my white, cad, yellow light, orange, transparent brown oxide, cobalt, and ultramarine blue. And I've got some transparent red oxide and some quinacridone red, alizarin, and some yellow ochre. So mainly I'm going to be painting the little pot. So I'm just going to mix up on my, this is just a peel-off palette I got from Michael's. I'm going to mix some of that ultramarine blue and some transparent brown oxide, and you'll see I get this kind of nice transparent wash for my canvas. So I also on my palette here have some of this Liquitex, just a liquid medium, and it's really handy to, you know, you can mix it in to your wash to spread that paint around and not lose its, you know, quality of the paint, because you if you add water, sometimes the paint can get a little, it just kind of starts to break down the paint instead of keep it, you know, the way it should be. Like this is great because I'm just using that liquid medium and it's keeping the paint perfect. If you do use water, that's fine. I do that too. But this is really nice because it just, the paint normally would start to kind of bleed into the canvas, but with that medium, what you're doing is you're just adding more of the what the paint is made up of into the pigment, and it's not diluting it, it's just thinning it perfectly. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to sketch out using some of that ultramarine blue and transparent brown oxide. I'm just going to kind of sketch out where everything's going to go. So I've got my, just kind of mark off where the bottom will be and that kind of that, where that top orange will go. And might want to just make this a little bit wider here. And I'm doing this video because knowing that acrylic painters may struggle with probably the application more than anything, trying to get this smooth silver pot done without getting it too dry too soon, or how to blend with acrylic is always the question. But there's ways around it. And I'm painting right in, you know, this is the wet into wet technique. So you can see that it's very similar to how I paint in the oil. So I'm just sort of sketching this out quickly, because the purpose of this demo is more to get the how of the silver. So I'll do my best to draw it as quick as I can, so you'll get the idea. So I'm just sketching this out. this has to come down a lot more. And then we got all these little edges. So I'm just, like I mentioned in the oil video, I'm just kind of looking at the angles while I'm drawing this out and the main shapes. This one comes in here. Now I just want to really make sure I know where my lines are so that I can really know where the top of the bowl is and then where my oranges start. So I'm just kind of going over that line, using a little more, just something different. So I'm using a little more blue so I can see that line clear. And like I said, with the oil, in the oil class, we have some ways of kind of checking our curves when we draw these things. So after I get this done, I'll show you. Okay. Okay, so if you flip it upside down, you can easily see kind of where I can, you know, correct my drawing. So you can just see the angles better. Something to do with it's all in that book, Drawing on the Right Side of the Brain. They talk about this and why it works this way, and I forget, but it's just how our brains operate. So I got the gist of it. So now for our silver mix. So I'm going to use the cobalt blue and some of that transparent red oxide. And I should use a little bit of that medium in there. And I'm going to add a little bit of white. So I've got, and I'm going to add a little bit of that yellow ochre to it to really kind of warm it up. And I'm just going to put some of that down. And I want to get that, you know, that dark layer in there first. And so I've got a little bit of that liquid medium in there, which is helping it stay, you know, go on quite nice and smooth. And just kind of getting in the, wherever there's the silver, I'm blocking it in. And and down here. So just getting that first layer in will help. And so then the next thing I want to do is I'm going to just kind of use some of that transparent red oxide and some orange, and just so we can see a little better, I'm gonna maybe add a little alizarin in there just to warm up the color down here, just to give it that real round look. And for this one, it's a little more yellow, so I'm just gonna block that one in with a little bit of that, add a little cad yellow light to the mix. And this one on this side, I'm going to add a little bit of that more red oxide and a little dab of, you know, brown, a little bit of brown oxide in there just to darken it, and some, just kind of something really warm in the shadow there. And this one comes a little further over. Okay, well now you get the gist of it, so that you can see where I'm going when I paint the silver. There's something in the bowl. So now I'm going to mix up another layer. I've got my cobalt and white and a little bit of the red oxide. I'm just bringing it up a notch so that we can, and I'll add a little of that yellow ochre just to really warm it up. And I want to make sure I leave this kind of more on the dark side, but I'm going to go ahead and look at my reference and kind of put in those little, those lighter marks. And I think I'm going to warm it up a little more with that yellow ochre because it's getting a lot of that reflection off the table. And then I'm just gonna kind of blend it in. My paint is still nice and wet there. So it helps to get enough paint down so that you can, you know, that you have something to blend with. If you put a little like thin layer down, you won't have much to blend in. So the more you kind of get in there, the better. Now for this highlight over here, I'm just gonna get a little bit more of that yellow ochre in there and just kind of get some of that light coming in here that comes across the bowl. So that's a little bit more yellow ochre in the mix. So the main mix I'm using is cobalt blue and some transparent red oxide and a little bit of white. And you can change the, you know, the brightness of it by how much of the white you add. And going to work in some of the lighter, those lighter rings there. So I'm just gonna get some white and some of that, a little bit of that cobalt into the mix here. And I'm going to, maybe I'm gonna start a little darker. So just mix less white into it if you want it to be darker. Some of that cobalt and red oxide and yellow ochre mix. And I'm just gonna go and kind of pop in those rings that I see in the bowl. And I'm using a number two width brush, so it kind of makes it easier for me to paint it in because I'm just using a brush that already kind of is, and I'm leaving a little bit of that dark in between so I don't have to do a lot of work later putting in the shadows. So once again, you can fix up your drawing. For some reason, this is a little tricky, this one, to draw, because there's so many different angles, and so it doesn't have to be perfect. That's the main thing. So now I'm going to add a little white and a little yellow ochre to that mix just to get a little bit of a lighter shade, and just kind of put in some of that lighter color in there as it wraps around. And then I'm gonna just kind of use those colors, and it's as you go to the back here, it gets darker because the light's coming from the right side here. But I'm just kind of working that in there. And now I want to go in and darken some of the areas. So I'm going to get some of that, some ultramarine blue and little cobalt and some of that brown oxide, and I really want to get that dark back here. That's going to make those oranges really pop out. So maybe add a little red oxide in there, because as it comes around, there's a lot of that reflected light there. And then back here, this has a little more blue. Mix a little more of that ultramarine because I really want it dark back here in the shadow. And, you know, add a little bit in there. And then get a little bit of your light mix here. You just kind of want to kind of blend that, soften that edge there. Just use your brush and kind of go over it. And then there's a little bit of a dark right there. And I'm just gonna get this darker here. So just get a little bit more of that cobalt mix and brown oxide or red oxide, whatever one you are using, and just kind of darken that in there. So we're starting to build our values up a little bit at a time. And now, before I go on, I want to get a little bit of that transparent brown or red oxide. And I want to just get that, maybe some brown oxide, just get that in there to, oh, there's some water there. to really make sure you have that shadow before you get your cloth in there. So just going to put that down. That way later you don't have to try to paint it in over the white. So just work some of that in there. And just really squint down and look at your values. I'm just darkening this a little more because it's quite dark up there. And you want it dark enough so that you can see your little highlights that you'll put on the edge there. Okay. And this is quite a bit darker here. Okay. So now that I've got my darks in, my mid-tone range and darks, I want to go and start adding some of the lights. I'm just going to get some of that nice cobalt and the mix I've been using, cobalt, transparent red oxide, and I'm just going to mix something up, add a little ochre to it, and I'm going to use the edge of my brush to put in some of those highlights. So I'm just using the edge. And I'm popping in that, you know, that where the light's catching the edge of the bowl. And then you can lighten it up with a little more white and go down here and just kind of work down some of that highlight down in here like that. And I just soften the edges a little. And then we're going to go put a little bit of a real bright up there. And I'm just looking at my reference photo and I'm looking at where all those light spots are. Like that. Now you can go back and kind of shape the highlight a little here. Just, you know, it kind of goes a little round up at near the top. So I just go back into my darker mix and just kind of just take off the edges a little. Like this. I'm finding this works really well. I didn't know how it would go with acrylic paint, and I think it's really doable. And then I'm gonna just go up one more notch. So I'm gonna add white into that same pile. And I'm just going to add maybe a little cad yellow light because I really want to get a bright highlight. I'm just kind of, and even up here we can put a real bright one. So when you get those highlights on, you can really see that we need to bring in a little more highlight of that tablecloth in there. So I'm going to get a little bit of that same color. I just added a little cobalt blue into that mix, and I'm just gonna get some of my medium, that liquid medium, and I'm gonna just add some of that highlight color in, just picking up the light. And if you use some of that liquid medium, it kind of makes it a little transparent. I'm just using my finger to kind of blend it in a little. Now, go back in and kind of put those little lines where the silver was bent at one point. And so it's getting that look of the tablecloth in there. And I'll work in some of that blue. So I'm gonna mix some cobalt and quinacrino red and some white and some of that, purple. And just dull it down with some transparent brown oxide and you got yourself a nice shadow mix for the table. So I'm just going to put a little bit of this down so I can show you how I would, soften those edges. Just getting some paint down so I can quickly show you. So down here where I finished off the bowl with the oil, what I did is I flicked some of the paint up. So I can do that with the acrylic. Just take your paintbrush and lift up like that some of the edges. And over here, you can just wisp up some of those edges so it's not so tight. And it works pretty well. So let's get some of that shadow color in there. And then another thing I'll see if I can do it in the acrylic, is I can take a little bit of that silver mix and just take your brush and swipe it off into the background there. I just did that just kind of soften it. And then if you want to get that little kind of, there's a little bit of a highlight here, I just... you can get something like a little bit of cobalt and white and some of this. I'm just mixing up kind of that silver mix because I kind of messed up that one. So if you make a mistake, you can just go back over it like this. And of course, with the ellipse, you can cut out how this pot wraps around. It kind of goes up and takes a nice curve. So you can cut out that shape there. And then same with up here to soften that edge. You can just, get some of this bluey gray mix here and just kind of soften it. Soften the edges. Now it's up to you how much detail you want to get in there. I'm just putting a little more highlight in here, but you can also put some orange into that mix and, get a little bit of that orange into your bowl so you can see a little bit of the reflection. So all I did is take the dark mix and add a little bit of that orange to it just to, whoo, that's a little too much. So I hope that helps with the silver mix. I was surprised. I had thought maybe it would be harder to blend, a lot harder to blend, but it was pretty okay. And just remember to leave your some of those darks in there. So make sure you get enough paint down before you start adding. Make sure you get that initial silver. Get enough paint with that gloss varnish, and I think you'll do fine. And remember, it's a good learning experience. Even if you don't nail your first silver painting, it's a really good learning experience. And when you do still life, it really sharpens your drawing skills. I should do more still life. And when you go back to something you really enjoy, like painting, a flower or birds, you'll find you're a lot better at it. Of course, when you're done and this is dry, you can always tweak your values by just using some glazing. So if you go and take your, this is probably pretty much dry. I know you're gonna laugh if you're, a colder climate. So you get a little bit of that liquid medium and take a little bit of that, brown oxide and that ultramarine blue. You got to use something kind of transparent, and you'll see it's like formed a transparent glaze. So you can kind of just glaze in some shadows over, and it helps you adjust your painting without, having to get too brush strokey. I can go around and just add the glaze to shade. Wow, that's a lot of fun. So look at that. Just with a little bit of, all I used was a little bit of that liquid medium and some of that ultramarine and some of the brown oxide, it created this glaze. So when you're barely putting color down, but you can really tweak your shading beautifully with that. You can even use a little brown oxide or and glaze your oranges and get a really nice look at that nice shadow. So remember, acrylic paint has its benefits because of the glazing. So don't forget to use them. Use your acrylic bonuses. So, anyways, I hope that helps, and I will send this link out to all of you, and I look forward to teaching you next week.